Good afternoon, everyone. This is Dong Che from Severance Hospital. I'm the co-chair of this live case five, the last live case today. And my co-chair, please.
Xu Jie Wu from Taiwan and Michael. So we have a lot of the expert here. So but because of time, I didn't. Maybe just can we have a name on the front of our every panel. So you started that live transmission from Asan Medical Center.
Okay, thank you for joining the afternoon the live case demonstration, and thank you for Professor Che and Professor Wu and Professor Li, and we also prepared another very interesting case. And I'm D.W. Park from Asan Medical Center. I'm introduced and the first assistant. I was a senior second grade fellow in the Yongsan Park, and the international fellow from Hong Kong is Felix. So, and Felix, can you present the patient background?
Thank you, Professor Park. It's my pleasure to present the case. The patient is a 71-year-old gentleman. He was referred for progressive exertional chest pain for 1 year. The CT angiogram done in other hospital already shows severe proximal LAD stenosis. Next slide, please. He had a history of ex-smoker and hyperlipidemia. Otherwise, the clinical presentation is mainly a stable angina. Next slide, please. The ECG was unremarkable. Next slide. The chest X-ray showed no significant cardiomegaly. Next slide, please. So the echocardiogram showed normal LV ejection fraction without much regional wall motion and abnormality. And the cardiac catheterization showed severe stenosis at distal left wing bifurcation, mostly as the osteo-LAD. And the mid-RCA has a mild stenosis. Next slide. So this is a baseline angel. RCA was pretty mild. Next slide. And you can see that from the chordal view, the osteo LAD has a quite significant lesion, and the mid LAD has a some moderate lesion. Okay. Next slide. And the spider view can delineate the osteo LAD lesion better. It's a very severe stenosis, and the osteo circumflex has a moderate, about 50% stenosis. Okay, so next slide. So today our target lesion is the distal left main bifurcation, and we plan to do an OCD guided intervention.
Okay, so and this coronary angio view, and today we checked this is a 7-French guidance cast by femoral approach, and you can easily see in the circle middle part there is some intermediate narrowing, and the aerial coronary view you can see the very tight lesion is added osseum. Distal left main is some intermediate ambiguous narrowing. And next one. So, and you can see this is the epicranial view, and the diffused disease was extended from the LAD ostium and to the mid LAD part. And you can see it's a very tight lesion, also some heginous region. And next one. So, and this is the most interesting part, and you can see a spider view, and the sulcus ostium is intermediate narrowing, and the LAD ostium is quite a significant narrowing, and by definition, Medina classification, and it seems like a 010 or 011. So at the, could you show us the aerial coronary view? So, and the, we are the, on the basis of the I was the angiography imaging, and we checked how much hemodynamically significant of a sulcus part and the LAD part. We checked the FFR first, and Yongsan, can you explain the FFR value for sulcus and LAD?
First of all, we checked the FFR at the LAD, and the baseline FFR was 0.82, and after hyperemia, it decreased to 0.55. And as well, we checked the FFR at the left circumflex, and the baseline FFR was this 1. And after hyperemia, it decreased just to 0.97.
So, and the distal from to the distal sulcus, the FFR value was 0.97. hemodynamically insignificant, and for LAD is FFR is in hyperemic status 0.55, and it's a very severe compromised hemodynamics the value. So at this moment, I would like to ask some comment from the moderator and the panel.
Detail reports, the selection of OCT versus IVUS, is any reason because of some calcium, or you want to show that different strategy, or maybe plaque modification you'd like to see more clear for the from the OCT?
Yeah, so, and you know, for this region, we can choose in the, we are published in Octopus trial and very diverse region, we can equally use the OCT versus IVUS, just except left main ostium is a sometimes dye injection is difficult. And for this patient, we use a seven French guide and caster without side hole. And the left main is big, and you can use the guide and caster without side hole. You can fully, clearly evaluate the whole segment, even using the OCT. And the two imaging modality shows it's comparable clinical effectiveness in our trial. And I select OCT in the two shows. How can you do OCT guided PCI? It's optimization, the algorithm is sometimes difficult to the interventional cardiologist. We have a lot of experience, long standing experience, more than 10 years, IVUS guided PCI, but there's some physicians still ambiguity about the OCT guided PCI. How can you do stent sizing? How can you do stent length? So I'm going to show so this is a very representative case. How can you evaluate the OCT guided PCI and the stent sizing and the stent length?
Hi, Dr. Wu, it's Michael. Yes, OCT would be great. It'd be nice to see the size of the distal left main, the Prox LAD. So when you stent across, what type of stent kind of mismatch from the Prox LAD to the left main? Now, with respect to IVUS and OCT, there is some controversy that OCT perhaps gives a slightly smaller measurement.
Yeah.
So you may underestimate. So what do you consider your true reference? Is it the OCT or is it the IVUS? So there's a lot of controversy.
Yeah, absolutely. This is a very important question. That phenomenon also seen in our Octopus trial. If you see all the comparative trial, OCT versus IVUS, like Illumine 3 trial and our Octopus trial, even though it's the same vessel, OCT measured parameter is slightly smaller than IVUS. The reason why there was some inherent technical difference. OCT, and on the basis of the PANTOM study published in the written by the Dr. Kubo in the in Japan, and they shows is the PANTOM study and the exact the lumen as well as OCT derived parameter and the IVUS derived parameter, and in terms of the lumen area, OCT provided a more clear lumen and intima interface. So, however, owing to the technical difference, IVUS provided some overestimation. Mm-hmm. So, and the reason why is the OCT derived the lumen area is much exacted true the value. So, however, it's a difference of the imaging, the difference and the technical difference is most data shows OCT derived imaging measurement is slightly smaller than the IVUS derived parameter. In the PANTOM model, exact value is much similar to the OCT derived parameter. So we checked the OCT. Could you show us the OCT? So, and the OCT is very helpful in the one shot evaluation is possible, and we do co-registration. We can
so
do
this is a manual injection, or you use a power
machine? This is a manual injection.
Not a machine.
Sometimes we use a machine and sometimes use the manual injection. This is just to use the manual injection. But however, looks like a machine injection. The reason why the technician is a very much experienced for. If you're going to use the guide caster without side hole, you can make some such like the very clear imaging, and could you show us the distal part? So, and the angiographic co-registration is one of the benefits of OCT-guided PCI. So, and looking at the the IBUS the OCT co-registration, you can see how much region was the long and how the significant. Could you show the overall image play? So, and this is the distal part, the severely narrowed. And then could
so
you
this
show?
Is not the Atron, the newer version of OCT. Is that still?
Yeah, yeah.
Still the old one, okay.
So, and the one chart is sufficient to evaluate the overall segment. You can see the added ostium is how much significant. Over here is Prax LAD. And also here, and could you stop? That is the most narrowed part. This is the added ostium, is how much is significant. Is the added ostium narrowing. Also, we check it up again, the conjunction point added ostium to distal left main. Could you show us the distal added ostium to the distal left main? Okay, show, okay, play. Okay, this is the mid LED part. So it's coming from the LED ostium. Here is the most narrowest part of LED ostium. And then sock wire is showing in the 11 o'clock. This is the most narrowest part of LED ostium. And then sock and the distal, here is the distal left main. So even the bifurcation, the PCI, the October trial published in New England Journal of Medicine, so OCT guided the bifurcation PCI, 20% used in the distal left main bifurcation. If you have enough experience, you can use the even distal left main bifurcation. You can usually do, you can do OCT guided PCI and is some timing, the injection timing OCT evaluation. You can make sure you can overall configuration up to the left main ostium. So, and I'm gonna decide to the stand from the mid LED to the, I would like to exactly positioning the LED ostium. So in the, we are usually measured and you're gonna do OCT guided PCI, you can use stand sizing is a two method. One is EM based or lumen based. That is the common consensus recommendation. If you're gonna use the distal part, EL was shown, you can one size down on the basis of EL. If EL is not enough to not shown, you can use a lumen-based sizing approach, one sizing going up. So, and this is the distal reference part. Could you show us distal reference? So, and the overall distal reference EL, EL, the diameter is 3.18. So, and if you select stand sizing, one size down, we can choose a 3.0. But EL was not shown on the basis of lumen-based 2.54, we can going up one size up. We can select the 2.75 or 3.0. However, this reference vessel shows the, you know, well, you know, the DMARC, the EL, we can select the 3.0 stand sizing. Also on the basis of the OCT, we can select where the stand sizing. And so after evaluation of the whole segment of the OCT and added OCR part, and we can put the 3.5, and the distal part, we can put the 3.0.
One of the questions—
That question, is our practical recommendation, OCT guided PCI.
Okay. One of the questions regarding that DW Park, you know, the OCT finding from the mid to the proximal, they have a mixed calcified and also they have a fibrofatty. So is there any specific lesion preparation before? Because you have some spot calcium, you know, for example, 180 degree of calcium. So maybe, you know, stent expansion will be a problem. So is there any specific lesion preparation? For example, you do prefer cutting or you like to do some, because IVRO is not available here, but of course, this is that we can do just balloon dilatation, or you prefer, you know, cutting, but prefer than the Scorflex, you know, than the regular.
That is a very, that is very important point. That this patient that did not have some circumferential calcium. At this moment, we don't do is a pre-region dilation. We just try to put the direct stenting. Okay, test.
Dr. Park,
Okay, here. Okay, test. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, this is Jang Wanbe from Chungking National University Hospital. I have just one question about your OCT examination. You have done that the one-shot examination from mid-LAD to left main, but you didn't do that in the subcomplex area. In the coronary angiogram, there is some, the sub diameter is not so small, it's big. And then posterior subcomplex, is there, there is some atheroma in angiography. And so if you do, if you did the subcomplex OCT or IVUS, so your stent strategy can be changed, I think. Do you have any idea about that?
Yeah, there is a very good point. So, and we have two different tools. One is a physiology guided PCI, and one is a imaging guided PCI. So I think, you know, some physicians suggest imaging guided decision making and the lumen area less than blah, 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 and the stent was better. But this, in terms of a clinical trial, there is no clear evidence you know, imaging guided PCI. So in the practically viewpoint, we use the physiology is decision making first, treat or not treat. Imaging was used the final stenting optimization. So we initially check it up the FFR in post branch LAD and SOC. SOC FFR was 0.97. We don't care. We decide to not treat just the OMT alone for SOC Austin. That is our first decision. But although our first decision, you try to do imaging. Imaging is sometimes a different morphology. But you should have some ambiguity about your decision making, treat or not treat. So we are totally, you know, decide on the basis of the physiology function in our cath lab. FFR value was 0.97, means hemodynamically not significant. So the reason why we just decide to treat the LAD. So, and then we don't care any imaging finding of the circle, the region. Okay, this is a 3.5. Okay. Its length is 23. Oh, 23이면 딱 맞나? This is 3.5. We try to exactly match. First time 해볼게요. 이제 오버랩은 되는 거다, 그제? This is the most critical point. We try to the exactly match. Okay, test. 이 정도. 오버랩은 충분하지?
네.
여기만 뒤, 아, 여기만 맞춰. 여기.
Maybe a spotter view would also helpful.
Yeah. Okay, test. Okay, we try to get the match and test. Okay, go ahead.
You mean a 9?
Yes.
9?
Okay. Stand slightly protrusion can happen. Is the angle is not quite wide. And then we do the final high pressure balloon dilation. So, and the, as Professor Baer is mentioned, sometimes we have some, you know, the ambiguity about the decision making and some physician select treat or not treat on the basis of the imaging finding. Some physician is based on the physiology only. So, and just in our center, we use the treat or not treat is based on physiologic value, and the final optimization was based on imaging value. Okay, and you high pressure, but how much?
Take the diag wire out now.
3.0 on the TA, NC balloon.
Would you take the diagonal wire out now?
Yeah, is usually and even after high pressure balloon dilation, is a diagonal wire pullback is usually okay.
So the Koreans' Medicare system is adapted, so you can use FFR while and also the imaging. Is that is
absolutely? That,
but in Taiwan, we cannot use that. As we can just only take one.
Only one.
Yeah. So this is a problem.
Physiology or imaging or just only one modality.
We can, for example, if the obvious lesion, of course, we use imaging because imaging guide PCI, but borderline lesion might be preferred to use at the
There are strict indication to use the FFR wire in Korea in Korean insurance, but the OCT in the IVUS out of the insurance. It's out of the pocket of hospital patient.
I think that's a change because be Renovate PCI shows better outcomes with imaging guidance.
Yeah, I have some question. Dr. Park, this is Donny from Jakarta, Indonesia. So I noticed that you, parking your stand right in the ostial, slightly protrude to the left main. Why not you use, stand from the shaft of the left main so you can do pot, short pot on the left main?
Is it again? I missed your question.
No. I thought that you're gonna put your stand from the proximal part of the left main, so you can do pot after that. And then I surprised that you pot POT. From the left main. But right now, like, I noticed that you right up from the ostial of LAD. Is there any reason for that?
Yeah, so it's looks like it's a circle ostium is not compromised. We try to the distal left main is by angiographically not involved much, and so we try to the exactly match the LAD ostium. Here is go 6, 8, 10.
12, 14, 16, 18.
Okay, please. 20. Okay, please. 자, 이거 가보자.
So one of the questions to Michael, because you have IVROs in US for this 20. Kind of what is the threshold for example you started to thinking about IVRO for doing a lesion preparation?
The indication for IVL would be considered quote unquote moderate to severe calcium, but in my experience I don't consider moderate an indication for plaque modification. Intravascular imaging with let's say 270 degrees arc of calcium. But if it's focal, I think you have a good chance of cracking it. If it's longer, so it's kind of a clinical discretion, but I think if it's at least greater than 10 millimeters and 270 degrees arc of calcium, you could consider perhaps, like Asan does, get an NC balloon to see if it profiles, not to go very high pressure, but if it doesn't yield, then at that point you have the option to do an atherectomy or IVL. Atherectomy is not an option if you dissect the vessel. So if you go too high of pressures and you dissect, I think that's why IVL is a good option.
So, and we try to the ejector position. Okay, Angel, ready? Good.
That looks great.
Yes, angiographically good.
We like to see OCT because somewhat protruding.
Yeah. many patients try to see the OCT result. Okay, good. Good. So, and many panel and audience try to see in the OCT imaging.
If for example, before you do the OCT, for example, if you have protruding into the left main, for example, 2 millimeter, you want to do additional parts, just short balloon for try to be optimized, opposition for the left main.
Yeah, so the part is not our routine, and some physician propose the part makes some more configuration, and instead of that, we do very high pressure balloon dilation. Sometimes the configuration is not circular, but we didn't do the part is routinely.
Okay.
Yeah. 여기서부터. 조금 더 들어갈까? 됐죠? 자, 테스트 살짝. 됐죠? 자, 여기서 하면 되겠다, 그치? 자, 타이밍 다 맞죠? 네. 준비됐지, 레디?
레디.
자, 푸샷. This is not machine injection. This is human injection. I trained our staff. So, So we will show distal part is a
great.
Okay. Great. 좀 크게 해서 okay, good. The side branch is coming. So, oh, there is some inner position area. Over a point. There is also some inner position area. Also, we can see and some proc protrusion. This is the proximity part. It's good. Can you see?
Great.
It's opening is added awesome is exactly matching.
Okay.
It's a very lucky case. Yeah. So in the middle distal part, there is some inner position. I apply the 3.5 balloon further, and then finally check it up the this optimization well. And I think this is a typical example of the OCT guided PCI. How can you do decide the balloon sizing and the stent length and the stent sizing? So and you know, although Illumin 4 trial did not show any clinical benefit, so, you know, the OCT guided imaging surrogate endpoint was met. However, clinical endpoint was not met. So, however, there are a lot of issues remained in Illumin 4 trial, and another big trial in from the Severance Hospital will be planned to present the next year ACC or ESC meeting. Will also provide additional the evidence about the imaging guided PCI. So, and everyone fully agree imaging guided PCI is very helpful in the contemporary PCI practice. And I'm very happy to show the typical example of the imaging guided PCI is how can you do OCT guided PCI.
It's fantastic. I think when people start using OCT, you realize how very clear and, you know, unambiguous, you know, interpretation is. Sometimes with IVUS, there's a lot of ambiguity, but with OCT, when the injection is done well, you can see everything really outstanding. I mean, with respect to the Illumin 4, I mean, the only difference was there was less stent thrombosis with the OCT arm, but in terms of hard clinical endpoints, there was no difference.
Okay.
I guess that Illumin 4, because the OCT expert doing angio-guided, but still using that previous OCT experience. So they are doing quite well. So the hard endpoint is difficult to make a difference.
So, I wonder if the investigators in Illumin 4, they're world-class operators, right? Yeah, right? So they may not require imaging-guided PCI. But maybe if you're not a world-class operator, maybe you need assistance
you need
where you're not going to go high pressure and risk perforation. It may make a mediocre operator a world-class operator. But if you're already a world-class operator, maybe you don't need imaging.
24. Okay, and then the final recheck. So we did additional the high pressure balloon dilation. Is the compared to the IVUS OCT benefit is a whole vessel evaluation is much faster, and then also provide the much clearer image of the stent morphology and the interrogation between the stent and the vessel wall. And the disadvantage is OCT. And should use the contrast injection. Also, some experiences required.
But code registration with OCT is very helpful to identify the location.
Anybody want to comment regarding the new system, Atrong, and compare with the old system? You know, some experience in Korea.
According to a previous study, OCTR, LAD OCTR stenting, after LAD OCTR stenting, the predictor of restenosis is left main proc burden, distal left main proc burden. So actually, OCT cannot see the proc burden. But in this case, we need just a single stent. Actually, angiographic physiologic study showed that this region is bifurcation, natural bifurcation region, 0, 1, 0 region. So I think OCT and IBUS might be similar result. Actually, I prefer IBUS if I do perform two stenting in left main region because multiple lung. But if I have excellent physician to do a single injection and then good imaging quality, OCT might be great.
Yeah. So and this is the final OCT imaging. As shown in the previous imaging, there is some severe metal position, and after applying the 3.5 NC balloon, there is no inner position, and this is a real optimization of the stenting, and this is how can you use the you know, imaging guided PCI. The lumen was fully expanded. There is no inner position, and that, I think this is a very the one of a representative case. Okay,
Park just pointed out, because OCT is going very fast, so the procedure, you know, sometimes it can be shorter than IBUS, because IBUS have to wait, you know, the pullback. OCT is running very fast, so this is, you know, that aided to the OCT guided the PCI. Yeah.
Doug, well, are you
can see the tensor very well, so this case showed very excellent, good position of stent. Congratulations.
Doug, are you using a 7 French or 6 French?
This is just the 7 French. 6 French, you can use the 6 French as well. Right.
So when you're using a 7 French, OCT for injection is a little bit easier. If you're using a 6 French, it becomes a little bit more difficult. You need to really inject with two hands, but it is a little bit more easier when you have a 7 French guide.
Yeah. All side branches, patterns, and the lumen was expanded well. There is no malposition. And the even though we publication Octopus trial, some physicians, how can you use the OCT-guided PCI? So this case is very helpful. You can do is how practically do OCT-guided PCI, even long lesion. And you have experience in the bifurcation lesion, calcified lesion, even distal left main bifurcation lesion. You have experience, you can do OCT-guided PCI. I'm not representative of Abbott.
Can you comment regarding the Artron system compared with the old system, if you have experience Artron?
Yeah, Dr. Park, yeah. So congratulations for your beautiful result. Actually, yes. Why I'm asking you the primary checking the left circumflex, the OCT, it's not a concern about the putting stent in the on the proximal circumflex. My opinion was, you know, after the putting stent, 1 or 2 millimeters the protruding in the left main area, sometimes it make a, you know, worse outcome in the ostium of the circumflex. And so I think that, but your position of proximal the stent area is perfect. Yeah, not even better than that. Yeah, it's very good.
Thank
it's
you.
Very beautiful.
Yeah. It's very lucky.
No, there is no rug in cast wrap.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, congratulations, and let's move to the next cast wrap. Dr. An?
Yeah, good afternoon, Dr. Che. So we also prepared one very interesting case. Our senior fellow, Dr. Zhou, will present the patient history.
Thank you for introduction. This is live case breathing. A 69-year-old male was referred for report chest pain. He has been treated with dyslipidemia. There was nothing special on past medical history. Next. He was quit smoking 3 years ago. His clinical presentation is stable angina, functional class 2. Next. Electrocardiogram shows normal sinus rhythm. Next. Chest X-ray shows no abnormal findings. Next. Echocardiographic finding was moderate hypokinesia at inferior wall and treadmill tested positive. Next. This is a baseline coronary angiography. Right coronary proximal was subtotal occlusion. Next. Left coronary angiogram shows very severe stenosis on the distal left main and proximal LAD. Next. Spider view shows clearly view the stenotic lesion. and mid LAD was intermediate region. Next. So we already fixed the RCA using stent, three stents, and this is the final result. Next. Now our target region is distal left main and proximal LAD. Thank you.
So this is today's coronary angiogram, spider view and aerocranial view. This is aerocranial view and caudal view, please. This is caudal view. So do you have any idea, any comments?
Hi, Jungmin, it's Michael.
Hi, Michael.
Hi. So you always get the tough ones. fortunately for you, I think, though, the ostium of the circumflex looks free of disease. So I think you may be able to get away with just crossing over. You have a high diag slash ramus that may be into play, but my thought would be, why are the high diag, wire LAD, balloon the prox LAD, see what happens, and you may be able to get away with a single stent crossover.
Is there any idea? Any other idea?
I totally agree with Dr. Lee's opinion. Actually, I think that LAD is a severely diseased and diffusely diseased, and so proximal LAD, the configuration in IVUS OCT is so important, and then where is the exact proximal, the landing zone of left main is important to making the selection of stent size.
So you, as usual, we perform the IVUS evaluation. So this angiogram looks very ugly, but look in detail, so we can find a good way, simple way, because the angiographically show that the circumference ostium looks fine, very widely open. First, the high diagonal is maybe concerned, as Dr. Lee commented, but the opening looks like that not that bad. Maybe the LAD, proximal LAD plug located maybe the opposite side of diagonal ostium. So we can confirm our angiography assumption on the IVUS evaluation. Could you show the circumflex pullback imaging? This is a circumflex pullback. Circumflex is very big. This is the opening ostium. So actually, the ostium of circumflex is, could you show us the ostium of circumflex? Okay, here is the ostium of circumflex. So ostium of circumflex is widely open. So LAD pullback, please. Pullback from the aerocranial view. Pullback from the septal, around the septal, this is the septal branch. And here is the flux LAD. Main concern is the high diagonal branch. High diagonal branch coming from the 11 o'clock. Yeah, LAD plug is the opposite side of diagonal branch ostium. So I think the occlusion risk of high diagonal branch and circumflex is very low. Could you show us the spider view? So looks ugly, but according to the IVUS finding, I believe that we can treat this patient only only using the short stent, one single short stent. Not short, but anyway, 22 something. So looks ugly. So, if you do the imaging and imaging basis analysis in your mind, so make it simple. So this is our catch plate of complex PCI. So could you measure the distal landing zone?
Is there any wire protection for the high diagonal branch?
Yeah, I already insert wire to the high diagonal branch and LAD and high diagonal branch. Definitely circumflex looks fine. So I didn't protect the circumflex already.
Yeah.
Okay. So my implantation view will be the aerocranial view. Okay, my I'd like to cover the, from the left main to just above the big septal branch. Could you give me the stem? I'd like to the direct stem because the most flock showed, it looks like a soft flock.
So you're pulling at a 3.5 stem?
Yeah, 3.5.
Okay.
3.5, how long?
24. So which companies and products?
Altimaster.
Yeah. Oh, Altimaster. Is Megatron, is Boston Megatron is available here in Korea?
Yeah, available. Tested.
If they have discrepancy of LED and LED, maybe Megatron with 9-cell design maybe is good. You can expand it even more than 1 millimeter, you know, diameters.
Depletion. Deflation.
So no pre-dilatation, you want direct stent, it's not calcified, yeah. Minimize yeah. Plaque shifting?
Yeah. And cost saving, save the time, save the money.
I heard that balloons in Korea cost almost $700. Is that correct? Somebody told me that.
U.S. dollars.
Yeah, U.S. dollars.
Okay.
In so the U.S., it's $100 for a balloon.
There is no risk of a high diagonal jail, so I'd like to pull back. And then could you give me the high pressure? And this is the NC 4-0. Because we have another live case, so I needed to do the fast procedure. 10.
It's 4.015.
4, yeah.
10. 4.0.
Yeah.
High pressure balloon. 16.
16.
Depletion. Left main is very huge. Test. Test.
Test.
Left main is huge. 16.
18.
18. Depletion. Depletion. 20. 20. 24. 28.
So what kind of NC balloon you are using? Because usually in the Arsan you are go up to 28 without breaking of the NC balloon.
Actually, I don't know the name. This is Sapphire.
Sapphire.
Sapphire NC, okay.
Yeah. Actually, I don't care.
Dr. Han.
Yeah?
I'm Bongiri.
Hi, Bongiri.
Many guys say the full expansion can be accomplished after enough inflation time. Above 20 seconds, but your inflation time looks very short. What's your opinion?
I fully agree with your opinion. Definitely. I need some slow down my procedure. So we need some time to fully expansion of the balloon and stent, particularly if we implanted a long stent or a long balloon. So this is a look at after I was evaluation. I was finding it looks fine. I will take the final angio and we'll finish the procedure. So I want to say that looks ugly coronary angiogram, but if you use the IVUS and in detail analysis of coronary angiogram, then you can make the, your complex coronary artery treated by the simple procedure. So imaging makes you free, imaging makes your complex coronary PCI makes simple. High diagonal looks fine. Here it looks already, so complex. Here is distal main. My concern is the position of proximal portion of left main. I applied a 4.0 high pressure balloon up to 28.
But good apposition, so, proximally.
Yeah. But some malposed area, but I don't think it affects the patient the long term outcome. Right. Test, please. Go back, four out. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So, this is my final coronary angiogram. The circumflex looks, flow is good. High diagonal flow is good. So, I just treated the looking complex looking coronary artery using the 22 3.5 stent.
So keeping the same standard, you know, the, keep it simple for the slogan at the PCI complex.
Doctor, thank you very much.
Great. Well done. Perfect.
Let's move on. SAPA, can you hear me?
All right. Okay. I can hear you. All right. So first of all, I'd like to really thank you for your all support our meeting and, you know, please enjoy the last cases, though, of the last cases. And so this is final. And so we, maybe, you know, Dr. Gang, Dr. Yonuche, Dr. Faisal from Kuwait. All right. So you do some case presentation first.
Yes, let me start presentation. This patient is 69 years old male, and he was referred for chest pain. And had been treated with hypertension, stroke, dyslipidemia, and hypothyroidism. Next. And he is an ex-smoker, and the risk factor is hypertension, dyslipidemia, and cerebral infarction. The clinical presentation is a stable angina. Next. EKG shows sinus bradycardia and the tube inversion in inferior lead. Next. Chest X-ray shows no cardiomegaly and there's no abnormal findings on both lung field. Mm-hmm. Next. Echocardiography shows normal LV systolic function and hyperkinase of basal inferior wall. Next. This is a baseline coronary angiography. There is a CTO region at distal ICA and collateral flow from left coronary artery. Next. We can see the tight region at left main and mild to moderate disease at circumflex and LAD. Next. This is a spider view. Next. And 3 days ago, we already fixed the ICA CTO region with the DS, long stent implanted. Next. So today, the target region is left main shaft, and we plan the device with IBUS. Thank you.
All right. Angiographically, it is clear that it's a shaft of left main disease. It's quite look simple, right? However, look at this. It's actually, we used the 7 French guider. So you can measure, you know, the proximal LAD. There are some diffuse, you know, disease. The reason why. Actually, the compared with the, you know, 7 French guider, it's just 2.5 something is approximately to with the portion. Would you show the other angle view? Okay, that's almost AP cranial view. All right, there are some disease, minimal disease, proximal LAD part, and some fluoroscopic calcium dose, and so, all right, that's all. So in terms of, no, how would you do that? Is there any suggestion for that, all right? Before the obvious findings? All right, this is spider. All POC area is a little bit, you know, larger, maybe some endovisual dilation, maybe related to by angiographic findings. Right? All right. In order to shorten our case demonstration, all right, would you show us obvious findings from circumflex and LED dose?
Circumflex first.
Circumflex first. Yeah.
This is proven from the circumflex. Mm-hmm. Our concern was the ostium of the circumflex because we are treated left main.
Mm-hmm.
And the proximal circumflex is non-diseased. And this is the ostium, well and wide opened. And this left main, there is severe stenosis. Mm-hmm. So,
okay, which issue was just ostium, circumflex?
Yeah.
All right. Big, you know. Yeah. POC area is somewhat related with the individual dilation. However, there are no disease at all for that. Okay.
And LAD, please. Mm-hmm. 더 완전 밑에부터요.
노멀부터. Okay.
Yes. Right. We check the IVUS from the mid LAD distal to the septal diagonal branch. There is a normal vessel with a minimal disease. And go to proximal. You can see that the diagonal branch comes in 5 o'clock and septal branch abruptly come in 10 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
After that, the branch came in and there's mild plaque and it begins to be more severe. The lumen is preserved in angio, but if you can, you see the IVUS, you can see the positive remodeling with a high amount of plaque.
Mm-hmm.
Here is the opening of the circumflex and this left main.
LED. Yeah. Ostium of circumflex.
Yes, ostium circumflex. And this left main here.
LED ostium.
Can you see, show the LED ostium again?
Mm-hmm.
Here.
All right. Charge ostium is here.
It's ostium.
Maybe, you know, pretty moderate amount of plaque.
Yes.
But minimal lumen area should be, what is it? 3.8 something.
Yes.
All right.
4.0.
4.8. Yeah. 3.8. Proximal LED. All right. So we have a little bit, you know, a discussion point. It's basically diffuse disease from the distal part of the diagonal branch and shaft of the main. So if we want to cover a whole lesion subset, actually, we need at least a 48 millimeter long stem, a big, you know, size long stem from the distal, just the distal LED, diagonal branches, and the main. And would you show us RCA? Right, area view?
Area view?
Mm-hmm. All right, perfect. So, actually, if another way, way of thinking is we choose the relatively short stem for the main shaft only, right? There are some diffuse disease and the LAD. And so we have a two choice. Short left main is around 15 millimeter something. So for big stem, 15 millimeter. And a 35 big stem, 48 millimeters, you know, from the shaft of left main and an LAD. And so we got a two choice. So what would you do there? What do you think? Just from the panel.
Hi, Dr. Park.
Just
it's Michael.
I was finding.
Yeah. So I think there's Glagoff phenomena. There's positive remodeling. There's a large plaque burden. If it were me, I probably would stent into the LAD and cover that plaque. I think when you had an MLA of 3.9, several studies show that 3.9 MLA correlates with some degree of ischemia. So personally, I would not just stent the left main. I would actually extend into the LAD. That's just me.
Mm-hmm. Lee, Michael, right? Your opinion?
Yes. Hi.
Any other suggestions?
I totally agree with Dr. Lee's opinion. Actually, RIO caudal view or spider view cannot see the LAD ostium itself.
Spider.
And I was showed large plaque burden. So, crossover the circumflex artery and stent into the LAD might be a good strategy. The issue is where is the distal landing zone?
Mm-hmm. any other short stand strategy you prefer? Any other panelists? Are you view again? All right, just Michael mentioned about the core value of 3.6, actually the positive FFR, matched minimal lumen area. Based on the meta-analysis, our data, some lab 2.7, some lab 2.4, and some meta-analysis by Greg Stone, actually mean lumen area 2.6 millimeter. Anyway, very short lesion, 2.6, however, long diffuse disease may be a little bit bigger, you know, MLA make us some positive FFR. However, for LAD, ocell part is almost 3.8 millimeter square, so almost 4 millimeter square. So actually, the functional issues, I think, is quite enough. However, technical point of view, right, we have some difficulties to place the, you know, short stand for the sharp area. There are some, you know, discrepancies between the LAD and so. All right, this is a kind of a trial. So we're gonna do, well-positioned 15 millimeters, short the main stand first, and then we're gonna do FFR. The meaning is we're gonna learn some, you know, some diffuse disease. However, minimal lumen area is, you know, 3.4 millimeters square. So issue is, how to deploy? How to deploy in terms of you know? Oh, are you? Oops. I think it's not easy. So, however, I will try that one. Test, please.
Test.
All right, can test, please. See, it's a little bit direct stand. To test, please.
Test. This is 4015
or 4018? Yes, 4. Test, please. All right, this is LAD. I don't want to touch very much proximal part. However, POC area is quite a big enough. Test, please. Test again. All right, this is, no, try that one, okay. Test again.
Test.
All right, Spada, please. It's a strike. You want to do the second test, please?
Yes, sir.
You pull the all just and system test, please?
Yes, sir.
Not easy, right? Test it. Here. Just a minute, test it. Test. It'll recover. Test.
Test.
All right. There's a test.
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 Maybe here we are. We have another. Wire in. Test.
Test.
Okay. Complete. Are you?
Not in presentation.
All right. The
presentation.
Let's see. Okay, this is full. All right, so we just want to see what's happened in a, you know, short limb mean picture first.
Mm-hmm. Looks good. The circumflex is not compromised. Mm-hmm. The LAD ostium looks okay. I think maybe a good 4012 NC balloon would be very helpful.
Okay, all right, secure again. Short shot, long durations. I think it's okay. All right. Anyway, we need a high pressure for, you know, it's just a stented site. However, I want to see what's happening in the obvious floor. Okay. And we're going to do how to optimize the, you know, a stented area. So we have to think about that. All right, just to see what's happening. Very interesting. Okay. Others? A little bit worried about, you know, the breakdown of the flag between the Prox LED and Tesla and main doors. However, we're gonna see. I think, as we know that, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Mm-hmm. Prox LED, we know that, diffuse disease. And issue is... We don't touch too much about, you know, Prox LED. And 4 millimeter stain is big enough to maintain the effect of minimal stain area for the main. Okay, perfect. So would you show us again the LED the main transition? All right.
There's a small dissection at the 6 o'clock.
All right.
A little bit of
stain
effect.
No, no, no. Prox LED for? Yeah. Further, all right. So the radio resonance related with some linear, yeah. Right? Partial dissection of Prox LED.
That's a progress.
Okay. Yeah. So, would you show us again? All right.
Yeah, copy top.
Once again. Mm-hmm. Okay. I don't want to touch too much. And however. Stand area concern is quite big, you know.
Yeah.
So, do you need a high pressure insulation for that? No?
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, it's already a main area. Distal landing is good.
It's pretty bad.
Not opposition is good. No malopposition. Mm-hmm. Stand area wise, almost, you know. 12 something.
Yeah. More than 12. 15.
12 millimeters. Yeah, almost there. All right. So, what do you think? FFR first,
check
and
FFR.
Then you want to decide what's happened. It's a complex wire.
Yeah.
I don't want to keep that. FFR?
Yes, that's FFR.
All right.
Wire.
I want to make some, you know, issues. However, there are some small dissection of Prox LED. However, look at this. What's happened to them? 48 millimeter, anyway, 48 millimeter long stain and 15 millimeter very short, you know, the main stain.
Flushing with the saline.
First.
Flushing. Yeah. Good. Flushing. Okay. Yes. Outside the left main, we'll make the zero. Equalize the pressure.
Mm.
And then the three-way.
Yeah. 4-0 is, if you want to use the 3-5, what's the thing? A little bit better. However, I think it's okay. Epigranular? Yeah. Have to show it.
Okay. It's a branch.
further. All right, good. Proof. You have to restart over there.
Okay.
All right.
Another branch.
Almost there. All right. Happy ground. All right. More. Okay, good. Proof. So, what do you think? Superior pH point. Wire a little bit further. Oil at 7 and 5.
0.85.
Uh-huh. All right. PDPA가 0.89인가? Probably. 0.8.
PDPA is about 0.8. Uh-huh. It's stabilized now. 9.2.
All right, just you know, we'll get some curious things about, you know, what of the physiologic changes after, even in the diffuse disease and minimal luminal area, 3.9 millimeters square.
And we are infusing the adenosine, by the 200 IV, and the pressure is down. Okay. PDPA is at 0.72, 71.
Strong push.
Yeah. All right. Now we prepare the wire. This is 69.
All right.
Do we stop? We have a block.
Stop. Okay, stop. And we, you want to do 35, another stand for that. Size or lengthwise, 15 millimeters, 32 is okay? 32. What do you think? Just a picture for us.
32.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Fast.
Thank you. All right. Some maybe lots of issues, you know, diffuse disease and some dissection, kind of, you know, turbulences. Yeah. All right. Lengthwise, 33?
Yes,
33 by 3. 3, 5. You're going to do a direct stem for that. Now our branch is good, so we don't worry about that. Right?
Sometimes when I have the FFR wire down, rather than pulling out the FFR wire down, I actually use the FFR wire to advance the balloon. So then after you stent, you could quickly do an FFR after, rather than, as you saw, it takes some time to take the FFR wire down.
Test push. I think it's 33 is wrong, you know. Touch the.
That's it.
Too much. It's okay?
Yeah.
Too much overlap. However, I think it's okay. It's a big vessel. Test please.
That's it.
33 is too long, however. Test, please.
Test.
What do you want to inflate?
Nominal.
Okay. Nominal first. Two, five. Okay.
14, 16.
16. 3.7. Actually, right, not much flag, and itself is a relatively soft one. So I think it's, we don't need a, you know, NC high pressure for particular cases. Okay. And we'll worry about the distal edge. Test, please.
Test.
Good. All right. Picture.
Enjoy.
Okay. Spider.
Spider.
I think it's perfect, right? So we're gonna do IVUS and see if no, we need some, you know, NC balloon. All right, so we passed planned time here. And so, all right, that's the last cases. Okay. Michael.
Yes. there's clinical judgment. Sometimes, you know, landing in the left main, going longer, there's always no right or wrong answer. And I think, but you did the right thing, I think, doing FFR to check the there's ischemia present after left main PCI was very good. Mm-hmm. I think we talk about left main CABG versus PCI. This is why we do left main PCI, because this patient will go home tomorrow rather than staying in the ICU for 5 days.
All right. Look at this, even in the long stents, you know, more than 3, 5, 4 millimeter size is quite enough in terms of, long-term TLR or something like that. That's, however, for these cases, I want to show, you know, some still, you know, discrete stents, shorter stent would be better. We have some cutoff at least 40 millimeter something. So, however, all right. I really, you know, discuss and enjoy these cases. So, all right, is almost there?
Yes.
All right, these final cases. I'm really happy to getting together to make this, you know, interesting meeting, exciting meeting. So I would like to appreciate our team. Bob, An, Gang, and maybe hopefully. Next year's meeting,
yes.
We're gonna have a more strong, you know, messages and make it simple. So, all right, Dr. Bug,
you. Yes. Thank you for joining the most of our audience and panel and moderator, and sincerely appreciate your support. It's a key essential part of this year's success of a complex PCI meeting. So I hope that everyone will join our TCTAP the end of April. Also, I hope to see in the next year the complex PCI 2024. And also we would like to our best to promote complex PCI part and do great job in the academic field. Thank you for your attention and participation. Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
See you next year. All right.
Thank you.